All right, guys, welcome back to another Big Iris production video. We've got another quick tip today on how to overclock your monitor. Now, you've heard of overclocking your GPU, you've heard of overclocking your CPU, but this is actually overclocking your monitor to go above the standard 60 hertz. So let's go ahead and jump into it. Right now, I am using a Dell ultra-wide monitor. You'll take a look here. It's the UltraSharp U3415W, 34-inch, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, it's got the ultra high resolution and whatnot. It's not quite 4K, but it's close. So first, what you're gonna do in order to overclock your monitor, you're gonna go ahead and right click on your desktop and go to your Nvidia control panel. It's gonna pop up these settings. You're gonna wanna click on change resolution, which is where we're at right now. All right, so as you can see here, we're running at 3440 by 1440 native resolution, and our refresh rate is set to 60 hertz, which is pretty standard, but we're gonna wanna try and overclock that, so we're gonna try and get above 60 hertz. So what we'll do is we'll come over to the right here, we'll click on customize, and over here you can see a list of custom refresh rates that I've already made here, but we're gonna go ahead and just ignore that for now. What you're gonna do is you're gonna click enable resolutions not exposed by the display. Then we're gonna go ahead and click create custom resolution. What that does is open up a little box here, and you can choose what the custom resolution you want. Typically, it'll just kind of leave this here since we want it to be at the same resolution. And what we're going to do is play with our refresh rate right here. Now, I've heard online reviews stating that the Dell monitor that I'm using right now can be overclocked all the way up to 80 hertz. So I'm going to try and achieve that today. So let's go ahead and start. Now, what we're going to do is I'm not going to crank this all the way up to 80. I'm actually going to go in intervals of 5. So first, we're going to start with 65. We'll leave this at progressive. Obviously, we don't want interlaced. Now, you can mess with the timing of everything. Typically, you don't want to mess with this. I just leave it automatic. Really, I'm not too familiar with what it does. But so far, since I've just left it automatic, it's been doing fine. So we'll just leave that the way it is. And what we do is, once we have this set, we go ahead and click test. Our screen goes black for just a minute or two. And it says test successful. Custom resolution, 65 hertz has been applied. Do you want to save this? So you can say yes, I'm just gonna say no. And now since I know that 65 hertz, I'm gonna jump up to the next level, which would be 70 hertz. For the sake of time, I already know that 70 hertz works, so we're gonna go ahead and jump all the way up to 75 and test that. Wait for just a second here, oh, and it was successful. It's been applied, you can save it, nope. And not to give it away, but I already know that this monitor can go all the way up to 80 hertz, so I'm just gonna go do it. We're gonna crank it all the way up to 80. We're gonna test that. And success. So I can go ahead and save that if I want. Click save. It's gonna go black for a second again. So here's the big question that everybody's been wondering. You probably wanna know what happens when you overclock your monitor to a refresh rate that it can't actually handle. What happens then? Are we just taking chances and hoping that it doesn't break the monitor entirely or fry something or whatever? Here's how you can find out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just crank this straight up to 85 hertz. Leave it here, and I already know that the monitor can't do that, so let me do this refresh rate, and so let me go ahead and show you what it does. We click test. It goes through the cycle, trying to figure out if it can do it or not, and it says the current timing input is not supported by the monitor display. Please change your timing input to 3440 by 1440 60 hertz, or another monitor timing listed as per the monitor specifications. So basically, it's just telling me, nope, the monitor can't go this high, sorry. And the good news is after about 15 seconds, it just jumps back to what it was before. So that's what's gonna happen. So that's a really good thing that you don't have to worry about, you know, your monitor breaking. The monitor basically already knows its limits, and so you don't have to worry about that. So anyway, I already know that this monitor cannot go above 80 hertz. So what I'm just gonna do is take it back down to the 80 that we tested. And I already know that it works, and it's in our custom resolution list here. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that. We can come up to here. Oops, no, we come up to the top here. Custom, click on that, and it'll show up. So all of the custom refresh rates that you just made will show up here in this drop-down menu. Make sure to come change it from here to custom, and then you can just pick this. I've actually been using 80 hertz for the last month, and it's been working flawlessly. Haven't had any issues whatsoever. What I did today is I switched it down to 72. typically because I do a lot of video editing and things, I work with a frame rate of 24 frames per second. 24 times 3 is 72, and so basically I'm getting three hertz, essentially, if you will, per frame of video. So anyway, just something to think about. That's how that works. Click apply. Again, the monitor kind of refreshes and you're done. So that's it. Easy way to overclock your system and get faster results for games, for, you know, whatever you want. And those of you who are actually wondering what the benefit of overclocking your monitor is, I'll go ahead and leave a little note or description down in the description area of this video. You can go ahead and check that out. I'll also put links. When you use those links, it helps us out. We appreciate it a lot. Guys, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you like the video, and we'll talk to you later.
Here. No, I'm not a writer.
Okay.